Hello and welcome to Unit 10. Let's discuss the law of absolute and the law of comparative advantages here in this video. Both laws are important in explaining the advantages of free trade. In this case, we're going to talk about the advantages of free international trade. Let's talk about the law of absolute advantages first. Let's say that we're looking at two example countries here, India and Holland. And let's also say that they can produce two products, soybeans and tulips. Let's also say that it takes India 6 hours, man hours, woman hours, to produce one bushel of soybeans. And it takes Holland 30 hours to produce one bushel of soybeans. These are all hypothetical numbers, of course. You can also see that it takes India 15 hours to produce one case of tulips. And it takes Holland 5 hours to produce one case of tulips. Let's first assume that they produce both products, perhaps equally, and that there is no specialization of labor. That means that at this point, then, there is no international trade going on between these two countries regarding these two products. But then let's take a look to see what would happen if they did specialize and if they eventually did start to trade. It's probably clear to you which country should specialize in which product. India, of course, is much more efficient in making soybeans. It only takes them 6 hours, so they're 5 times more efficient than Holland in making soybeans. So they should specialize in that. And Holland only takes them 5 hours to make the case of tulips, compared to India, 15 hours. So Holland is 3 times more efficient. So we can say that India has an absolute advantage in making soybeans. And Holland has an absolute advantage in making the tulips. So let's say that India chooses to produce 100 additional bushels of soybeans. Now, 100 bushels at 6 hours per bushel means that India is going to spend 600 hours on the bushels. Now they would have to, let's say if they're currently at full employment, they would have to cut back on the other product. So they would have to cut back on the tulips that they were previously producing. And in order to cut back on that same 600 hours, so 600 hours in the tulip production cost them 15 hours to make one case of tulips, they would have to give up 40 cases of tulips. Holland is specializing in tulips. So we're going to make them add 100 cases of tulips to their production. It costs them 5 hours to make each case. So it's going to cost them an extra 500 hours for the tulips. And 500, now they're going to have to give up the production of soybeans. So 500 hours that they're going to apply towards the tulips now, they're going to have to give up. It had cost them 30 hours for the soybeans. So they're going to have to give up 16 2/3 bushels of soybeans. So if we look at the overall soybean production in the world, India has increased its soybean production by 100. Holland has cut back on soybean production by 16 2/3 bushels. So the total gain is 83.33. Tulip production has gone up by 60. As you can see, Holland increased its tulip production by 100. India cut back by 40. And so 100 minus 40 is 60. So now the two countries can trade. And so if India sold its additional production of soybeans to Holland, and Holland did the same thing selling tulips to India, they would each end up, let's say if they split the difference, with more than 40 bushels of soybeans and 30 cases of tulips. So as you can see, specialization, in other words, making products that you're best at, will help overall total world production. So if these two countries were to trade internationally with each other, they would both be better off. Now you might ask yourself, what would happen if one country produces both products more efficiently? In the example that we're looking at right now, as you know, India is more productive in making soybeans and Holland is more productive in making tulips. But let's say hypothetically that India would be more efficient in making both products. Of course, it's purely hypothetical because Holland, of course, is most efficient in making tulips of any country in the world. But just for the sake of this example, let's assume that. So we're going to change the 5 hours that Holland was taking to make the tulips to 30 hours. So now, should the two countries still trade, since India has the absolute advantage in making both products? Well, let's take a look at the same numerical example that we did with the previous numbers and find out if there's any benefit for these two countries to trade. First, we have to determine which product each country should produce. India is 5 times as efficient in making soybeans as Holland, 5 times 6. And India is twice as efficient in making tulips. So we can conclude that 5 times more efficient is better than 2 times more efficient. So India is most efficient in making soybeans. So that's the product they should be specializing in, and Holland should be specializing in the production of tulips. So let's say that India produces an additional 100 bushels of soybeans, and they're going to have to give up 40 cases of tulips because they're spending 600 hours more on soybeans, and 600 hours in tulip production means that they give up 600 divided by 15 hours, or 40 cases of tulips. Holland is going to specialize in the production of tulips. So let's say that they increase their production by 70 cases of tulips, and it takes them the same number of labor hours to make tulips as soybeans. So they're going to also have to give up then 70 bushels of soybeans. So the overall production of soybeans is plus 30. And the overall production of tulips also goes up by 30, 70 minus 40. So even in the case where one country is more efficient in making both products, in other words, it has an absolute advantage in making both products, it is still a good idea for each country to specialize, because each country has a comparative advantage in making one product. In this case, India has a comparative advantage in making soybeans, and Holland has the comparative advantage in making the tulips. As you can see, total world production goes up by 30 products for the soybeans, as well as 30 products for the tulips. And if these countries now trade and split the difference, they will both be better off.